So if today I stand in a party which thinks that the Quebec people has the right also to decide one day about their future in total freedom, in a democratic way, and have the right, if they choose so, to declare their independence, it's through that experience, that personal experience. But what that being said, I have to say also that all my life, I have also been an internationalist. Is it the right word in English too? So before being an independentist, a sovereignist, I'm an internationalist. And I think the fight for the preservation of the identity of Quebec people, of its cultural aspects, of its language, of its presence in North America, is a part of our fight for the diversity, which is so important with for our civilization as a humanity. It, as in biology, as in ecology, diversity is common drum in ensuring the strength of a community. And for a human community, it's totally consistent with our pluralistic approach and internationalist approach to humankind evolution to preserve the diversity of its cultures. So it's only in that framework that I define my fight and my resolution to be with the Quebec people to ensure that they have every means, if necessary, to preserve, every means necessary to preserve their identity, their culture, their language. How are we going to ensure that? What's the difference between us and the PQ? The main difference is in the fact that we don't want to do it alone. We don't think that it is something that has to be carried by French Canadian and de souche ethnically defined French Canadian people. It's a social project that could be the project of all people living in Quebec. For us, appartenir. Belonging to Quebec has nothing to do with race, has nothing to do with our origins. It's a question of choice. It's a question of citizenship. Is Quebecer whoever wants to be Quebecer? And there is no obligation in that sense to identify with the ethnic origins of Quebec, but for a common, universal approach to our society where we share common values, we share common objectives, and we want to strive for that. And for that regard, we think the most important consideration in that process should be its democratic process, the democratic character of it, so not to trap people in being forced into independence. We say, if you're not convinced that independence is necessary, sovereignty is necessary for Quebec to attain its social objectives, its contribution to humanity, the preservation of its culture, it's okay. We can work together. We commit to ensure that the process will be democratic, and we're going to discuss first about what we want as a common project in the Constitution, in a very participatory way by citizens' assembly, which is in fact the what we call a constitutional assembly, as a lot of modern processes have taken place in Latin America, where people have gained a lot of freedom, a lot of power through processes of constitutional assembly. I don't want to go into detail, but it's the case in Brazil, it's the case in Ecuador, in Bolivia, in Venezuela. So we want to tap on the best practices to ensure the participation of people, and we think the day we'll discuss about that, everybody has the right to participate in that, even those who are opposed to the independence of Quebec. First, what unites us, what is the global project, the political project we want for Quebec, and then at the end, decide about the future, the political future of Quebec. Is independence necessary or not? Some are not convinced of that. I am convinced that the independence is the natural consequence of that building up of a specific project for Quebec. But we'll decide in a democratic way in due time without enforcing it to anybody.